Hello my little butterflies, welcome back to my channel, and I would just like to say fuck beauty pageants. When are we going to stop drilling into little girls' heads that beauty is something that only scratches the surface? That if you can't squeeze into a size 2 or flung around in an itsy bitsy bikini, you're not beautiful. If you don't drown yourself in a boatload of makeup every day or have big suffocating hair drowning in hairspray, you're not good enough for the world. When are we gonna practice what we preach? Y'all know beauty is something that's on the inside and that's all that matters. And if that's so, then why don't we put intelligence and confidence above so-called beauty and body imaging? Just stop lying to our daughters and tell them the truth. And the truth of our society is, the girl with the long, beautiful hair, stick figure body, and a whole makeup aisle for a face will always be handed more opportunities than the girl with the kinkier, short-length hair, curvy figure, and natural face, but has the most beautiful fucking soul you can ever imagine. It's time they knew the truth of what they're up against, and not the lie the world tried to sell them. A good makeup job equals first place, but yet a good personality plus intelligence equals runner-up. So you guys, I wrote this poem because I just feel like the world is always saying, well, yeah, beauty is on the inside, or beauty is the eye of the beholder, yet we always, you have to look a certain way to get ahead in life, you know? You have to have makeup on, and you have to look beautiful, and your hair has to be done a certain way in order for you to get ahead in life. You can't just, you know, roll out of bed in the morning and just put on sweatpants and a t-shirt and people take you seriously. You have to do extra just to get what you want in the world, which I think is crazy, because you tell me beauty's on the inside and, oh yeah, people don't judge you based on how you look. That's bullshit. The world judges you based on how you look. And I just wish, you know, people, and I, don't worry, I will definitely teach my daughter that beauty is on the inside. That is something that's on the inside. But I want her to know that the world will always look at you a certain way if you don't look a certain way. You know what I'm saying? If you don't look, I'm not gonna tell my daughter to wear a boatload of makeup. I don't wear a boatload of makeup. I have makeup on in this video, but you'd be surprised how much I have on. Like, I don't wear a whole lot of makeup, and I don't wear makeup that often, especially how I used to wear makeup. I used to wear makeup every fucking day. I don't wear it. You lucky you catch me with makeup on once a week these days. It's just when I feel like putting it on. But I don't want my daughter to feel like she has to wear makeup and she has to have weave in her head and she has to, you know, have her body look a certain way in order for people to take her serious and want to be her friend and want to give her opportunities in life. And that's what the world is becoming today. You have to wear makeup. You have to have long weave in your head. If you're walking outside with your natural hair, nobody wants to take you serious. They have women with beautiful dreads, their natural hair that they dread up, and no one wants to give them a job opportunity. No one takes them serious because they don't have the long Becky hair. So it's an issue now. I wish the world would stop being that way. But yet in school you tell girls that beauty is on the inside. It doesn't matter what's on the outside, but yet that's how you look at people. If she doesn't look this way, then you can't be her friend, or you don't want to approach her because she doesn't look like this. I want to teach my daughter that beauty is on the inside. And you can have a beat ass face with makeup, but have a nasty ass attitude and nobody will like you. You know, I don't want her to feel like she can't ever wear makeup. She can wear makeup, but I don't want her to feel like the makeup is what will make her. You know, I don't want her to feel like makeup makes a person. You make yourself. Your personality is going to ultimately shine out. That's what's going to ultimately win people over, because they can have a beautiful female walking down the street, you know, long, you know, straight hair that, you know, she could do this with and shit and have a beat ass face, you know, and a bomb ass body. They have a nasty ass attitude and nobody will want to deal with her, and they will see that nasty ass attitude, and that's going to overshine all the makeup she has on, all the time she took in the mirror with her hair this morning. Her personality is gonna decide how people perceive her, even though ultimately your first impression is people just look at whatever you have on the outside, you know. It's, oh my god, she has like this expensive ass purse or these expensive ass shoes, so oh my god, she must have money, you know, she must have power and all this, and that's not true. Some females these days will buy a damn $2,000 pair of Louis Vuitton shoes, but will still be living in their mama house because they can't afford to live on their own. But you got $2,000 to spend on shoes, boo-boo. Or they'll spend $10,000 on a fucking handbag, which I'm sorry, I don't care if I was rich. I would not spend this money on a bag. On a purse, but yeah, you still catching the buzz. I think you need to get yourself a car. You know, see, people's priorities is fucked up these days, and I think it's time for people to actually teach little girls how the world is. Like, I want my daughter to know how the world is, how the world works, but I still want her to feel beautiful with herself and comfortable with herself, but I want her to know this is how the world works, because then you don't see, because, you know, you learn the hard way. And I think I'm one of those girls in that generation where you're at home and, you know, your parents are always trying to tell you it's not what's on the outside that matters, what's on the inside. But then when you go out in public and, oh, well, they like this girl better than me because she has weave in her head and she has makeup. Well, I need to be like her, and she's skinnier than me, and I need this body to be like her so everybody can want to be my friend. No, but I wish they would teach, you know, I don't want my daughter to be like that. You know, I was like that. Like, I was a mad ass tomboy. You never caught me with makeup on. You didn't. The only thing I ever wore was pants and basketball shorts. And I mean shorts, like men's shorts. They had to be touching my knees, okay? I didn't feel comfortable in dresses. I didn't feel comfortable in booty shorts. I didn't feel comfortable in skirts. I didn't feel comfortable in anything girly. You couldn't catch me in makeup. You're lucky if you caught me with my hair down, which was very rare. My hair was always in a ponytail or in braids, nothing else. Like, I was a mad tomboy. I was the only girl. I grew up in a house full of boys. The only girl. I rough played. I wasn't, you know, this delicate little flower that's, oh, that hurts. No, I would be the one at school with more guy friends than girlfriends because I played rough like them. You know, let's play basketball. Let's play football. You know, I wasn't, you know, girly and sensitive about, and it hurts. I wasn't like that. So I did befriend more guys than girls. But then when I started to notice, like when I actually started to like want to like boys and like dig boys, it's like, oh, he likes her because, you know, she's girly and she's ditzy and she has the nice straight hair and she has the makeup and, you know, she has the, you know, the curves in the body. Now, don't get me wrong, I have curves now, okay? I had curves before, but I wouldn't show it because I would always wear baggy clothes. That's what I felt comfortable in. And then when I started noticing that, then I'm like, oh, I need to wear makeup then so I could be like that. And I want a whole bunch of friends too. I want to have a whole bunch of friends and a whole crowd of people that know me too. I used to be like that. I don't know what hit me one day. I was like, well, fuck it, shit, I don't care. I have two best friends that I still have today. And they're the best friends I got asked for in the world. And like, I would not trade them for nothing. And it's like, I didn't even care if I had 50 million fucking friends, because a good 90% of them ain't even your friends. They just know you, you know? And I don't know when it hit me that I don't fucking care about how they look at me or how she see me or what she think about me. But it hit me one day and I was just like, fuck it, I don't care, I'm gonna be me. Now I transition back and forth. I can have on sweatpants and have a beat ass face and don't care. I can have basketball shorts on and some high tops with a baggy ass t-shirt and beat my face, okay? Like, I'm a good mixture between like really tomboyish and girly. But don't get me fucked up. I'm still, y'all know. But I don't want my daughter to feel like she has to be someone else, you know, because she gets all this because the other girl gets all the attention because the other girl wears makeup all the time and she has a body that I don't have and everybody's paying attention to. I just want her to know that sometimes all attention isn't good attention, you know. That's what really drove this poem for me, because I thought about that, I thought about my experience, and I thought about what I want my daughter to grow up knowing. You know, I want her to feel comfortable in her own skin and like know who she is as a person and not worry about what she doing. Or what she did it, I'm like, okay, well, if she jump off the roof, are you gonna do it too? You know, I want her to be her own person and, you know, be a leader of herself. I don't want her to be a follower. That's pretty much what drove this poem for me, because I'm scared that my daughter is gonna go to school and, oh, well, she does, and, you know, pick up habits that she didn't have because, oh, she doing it and she get all this attention. It's like, it's not about that. And I don't like being the center of attention now, but, like, I'm really shy. Like, real shit, in person, I'm shy. Like, when I first meet you, I'm shy as shit. I don't want to be the center of attention. I don't know how my wedding is going to work out because I really don't like to be the center of attention. Like, y'all, like, I dance around my house and I'm goofy and stuff around my house and stuff, like, and like, people that I'm close with. But in public with a lot of people, I'm like really shy. I'm almost like a turtle. It's crazy. But that's how I am. I don't know how my wedding's gonna work out, because I like to dance, I do, but I get nervous in front of a lot of people and I'll be like, I'm gonna be quiet, let me get in the shadows, you know. I don't really like to be in the center, but we'll see how it's gonna work out. But that's gonna be going on next year.
2018, hello, I'm getting married, hello, June 2018, y'all.
don't know, I'm really hyped up today. I don't even know why I'm turned up today like this. But thank you guys for watching my video. That's all I have for you guys today. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.